The 2015 season is here, and the biggest names in the world of action sports have come to San Diego to throw down on the rough, tough, and muddy course called Terracross. Off-road truck racer and former Terracross champion RJ Anderson is back to reclaim his title. He'll have to defeat last year's champion, the dark horse Jason Luber. But this year's courses are tougher, and the competition is thicker. World-class motocross riders like Jeremy Twitch Stenberg and Ronnie Feist joined the ranks against an already stacked roster. The competition is sure to be fierce. Terracross is back. Hello and welcome to the Del Mar Fairgrounds and Racetrack, home and current host to the world-famous San Diego Fair, celebrating its 79th year. Today we bring some horsepower to the horse track as we kick off the 2015 Terracross Championship. Hi everybody, Kevin Barnett alongside Paul Thacker, and over the last 3 years, Terracross has attracted some of the biggest names, Paul, in off-road truck racing, motocross, UTV, snowcross, motocross, snowmobile, freestyle, and X Games champions like Colton Moore, Jeremy McGrath, and others. Because of the incredible field of drivers, supercross-style courses, Terracross has established itself as one of the most fun and exciting race forms in the world.
That's right. We've got some amazing athletes returning to the scene this year. We've got Leapin' Levi LaValle looking for his first podium in Terracross. We've got action sports personality and radio star Jason Ellis, as well as X Games medalist Colton Moore and off-road truck superstar RJ Anderson. RJ won the championship in 2013, but lost the crown last year to our dark horse, Jason Luber. Luber was the epitome of consistency last year. Didn't actually take a win, but this year he's looking for some wins as well as a title.
In Terracross, they all race stock machines identically prepared. It really comes down to the skill of the driver.
I think the coolest thing about Terracross is everyone is in the exact same Polaris XP1000 Razor.
It's basically just driver and adapting to the track and adapting to the surroundings.
It's not about money, where someone can put money into a car and build up a motor. It's you, the driver, against, you know, who you're driving next to.
I think at the end of the day, the best driver is going to do good, so hopefully I'm one of them.
Focus on what's going to happen on track and what has happened so far. These athletes already qualified for our main event. Still four spots up for grabs coming up here in the LCQs, Paul.
Yeah, in the LCQ, there's no room for mistakes. You're either making it or you're going home.
Before we get to live action, let's give you the Keystone Automotive keys to the course in one lap here at Del Mar.
Such a great track this year in San Diego. Right out of the bat, you got two really tight corners. Got to be careful not to get tangled up. Set up for the two lanes for the big over-under jump. This is really a great feature on the track. Comes into two big double-doubles. Got to be really careful not to mess up on that section. Set you up into three lanes. Now, this is really important to set up for the next section of concrete. Really important last year as well.
Saw a lot of passes. We saw some wrecked vehicles in this section.
Yeah, it's really a place where guys are making it or break. A lot of passes happen in that section. Brings you over to the big tire jump. Guys, are some of them rolling and some of them are ending up upside down. It's a cool feature. Come back outside, big double, and you're starting another lap.
Seems like every year the course gets bigger and badder. Cars on track. Let's go down to the third member of our broadcast team, Laurette Nickel, with Levi LaValle.
Levi LaValle finds himself racing in the LCQ due to, in his words, stupid racing mistakes. Now needing a top two here. Levi, how are you going to manage your race and advance to the final?
It's going to be a tough one, you know. It's crazy being out here. All these guys are so competitive. So I'm just going to try to get a decent start and just ride a smooth race. You know, if I can eliminate some of the small mistakes, hopefully I can get into that top two and get into the final.
How do you eliminate those small mistakes?
The biggest thing for me is I really am just... all aggression, so I'm just out there giving it, and I need to like just calm down and just drive, you know. And that's if I can do that, I think I can make it in.
All right, well, wishing you a calm race. Good luck to Levi LaValle.
Love the race suit there, yeah, on Levi LaValle.
The bow tie, that's pretty fancy. He's dressed for success.
Brought his formal wear. Let's take a look at who's in this LCQ. Jason Ellis out of Hollywood, California up front.
Yeah, Jason, he likes to talk a big game. He ended up upside down a whole lot last year.
Darren Parsons in what appears to be a borrowed UTV.
Yeah, whatever it takes, right? This is the LCQ. Don't hold anything back.
LaValle there on the outside of row one as we take a look at our Optimus start grid. The other three drivers joined by Sylvester Guthrie Jr. And then his coast check there, he's an ultimate fighter. Keep him in the cage, please.
He's a bad man. You don't want to mess with him.
We are underway here, LCQ number one. Ellis off to a good start, LaValle also, but not moving in the front row there was Parsons.
Yeah, not sure what happened there, but I tell you, Ellis on that inside line, that's definitely where you want to be off the start.
Contact, as usual, going through the first couple of turns, and there's Ellis. That is not the race line.
That is not. Him and LaValle got together. He does not look happy.
Trying to put it in reverse. Meantime, out front now, LaValle on the 108. And behind him, the 42 of Sylvester.
Yeah, those two big jumps coming to the arena are so important. You have to really nail them. Seeing some guys take a little bit short, a little long, ending up upside down.
Coast check in third as we get a look at the GoPro onboard with LaValle. Inside the 108, you see the amount of input he has to put into the UTV there. This course is challenging.
Yeah, that's that really slick concrete section. You can see the guys setting up differently. Levi going outside, open the door wide open for Sylvester to put a little bumper into the side of him there.
Sylvester finding a little extra braking power on the wheels of LaValle.
You can see these guys coming in, hitting the Mystic Mangler. Some of them going big, some of them kind of a little bit shorter, a little cautious. It's a gnarly section.
Couple of clean corners now for LaValle, and he's getting a little bit of a lead trying to check out.
Yeah, these Polaris Razors, look how, it's just amazing how well they get through this nasty rough track. The things are just, they're like mini trophy trucks nowadays.
So if LaValle gets away, look for that second spot. Remember, six racers, six laps, but only two spots as we're back on board with LaValle. So LaValle up front, Sylvester. And look at coast check right there, just a couple of seconds back.
Yeah, third spot, not bad. He has a little bit of time in a Razor. Pretty sure he has one at home. This is definitely the first time he's ever raced one, though.
Yeah, he's a little bit back. Third looks good right now. Won't look so good at the end of six laps when you're going home. Now back onto that concrete section. So tough, this approach.
Yeah, it's so slick in there, and I mean, you'll see guys setting up different. Some of them coming in hot, going wide. Like Levi there, he went a little bit short, cut the corner. But I tell you what, it's the most challenging section of the track by far.
Tell you, cutting that corner that time was Koscheck. He's inside into second.
Yeah, that was definitely a mistake by Sylvester, and Koscheck took advantage. He's looking for his first final.
Koscheck in that Terracross 77, driving it hard into the next corner. He may be thinking about first.
Yeah, he's looking really good, although LaValle's pretty relaxed out front. He's got a nice cush lead. Although mistakes like that aren't gonna help him any.
LaValle hard on the brakes, now into that gap section. So important. I remember drivers talking about you cannot come up short.
Yeah, absolutely. That is a true gap jump. There's no safety there. You have to hit it perfect. Yeah, coming up short's a bad plan.
Back on board with LaValle. He'll go back along the stands. He's solidly in first place halfway through. Look now at Koscheck coming down. Right-hander, he'll head towards the concrete. But no,
no,
mistake!
Big mistake by Koscheck. I tell you what, it's that concrete section is really getting guys. It's so slick in there.
We're used to seeing it bite drivers at the end, not the start. Koscheck still sitting there, the yellow flag waving.
Yeah, he's got to let all those guys go by before he can pop that thing in reverse and get back on track.
Levi LaValle looking good to go through LCQ number one. A win will put him in our main event.
The 2015 Terracross Championships on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Polaris Razor. By Mystic Lubricants, the official racing lubricant of Terracross. Learn more at mysticlubes.com. And by GoPro, the world's most versatile camera.
The white flag waves on LCQ number one. One lap to go here at the 2015 Terracross Championships. Race number one, two spots up for grabs in the main event. Levi LaValle looked good for number one, but that is the 42 of Joe Sylvester in second for the moment. He's getting a little bit of a challenge.
Looks like Mitch Guthrie has worked his way up into third and definitely putting some pressure on Sylvester.
GoPro on board once again with Levi LaValle negotiating that tricky concrete section, but the racing to be had. UTV Underground and Walker Evans, Mitch Guthrie Jr. There he is, 23, he's in the picture.
He's making a push there, definitely putting some pressure on Sylvester. We'll see if he can make a move here. God, it's so slick in that corner right there.
Spins out.
Just as I say slick, he does a complete 360, and that will end his chances, it looks like, for the main.
I didn't see any donuts on our track map earlier.
Yeah, that's a tough section, no doubt. And it definitely caught up to Mitch.
Those two spots almost looking decided. Levi Lavallee, checkered flag waves. He throws it to the crowd. He is in the main event. Second spot, hard fought here. Sylvester fought off a couple of people for that second spot.
I got a little squirrely there bouncing off the bumpers before that big gap jump.
Driving it to the end. Action hot, furious here, San Diego. This was the start. LCQ number one, Ellis off to a good start.
Such a good start. Him and Levi got together there a little bit, but I thought Ellis was really going to make his move in this LCQ.
Ellis was out quickly, and then a good move in the middle of the race from Koscheck.
He was in second in a transfer position, then a big mistake coming out of the concrete section ended his afternoon.
That concrete section played a role. That was the last lap right there.
Just spinning donuts out there. It looked like he was having a good time.
So Guthrie Jr. is out. Levi Lavallee is in. Two drivers will advance for our first LCQ. It's Lavallee and Sylvester. Four drivers going home.
Yeah, Lavallee, no stranger to winning, but only on the snow. This is his first win on four wheels.
So a good one for Lavallee and a good day to be out at the Del Mar Fair for these young fans. This is a huge highlight Terracross and a unique thing for them to see. Let's see what the drivers have to say about this track.
Here in San Diego, the track is kind of unique. We have the smooth concrete floor to work with. To promote passing, we make split lanes everywhere. Because otherwise it would just turn into a train track. Everybody would follow each other.
Pretty much one guy goes right, you go left. Don't follow here at Terracross. You got to be able to pass.
We got the concrete, slick asphalt. You got the big jumps. You got the big whoops, tire obstacle. It's a lot of chaos. Of course, beating the track itself comes first and foremost.
No doubt the track a factor in this one, the concrete getting a ton of attention.
Absolutely, it's really a section where guys can make up time or lose it just as easy.
LCQ number two, Daryl Rath up in the front row. Remember, two more spots, the last two spots. James Hill maybe gonna take one of those.
Yeah, this is, again, Andy Ives, he's ready. He's no stranger to this Terracross racing. It's the LCQ, man. There's only two spots, so you better be on the gas.
Optimus starter start list right here. Mike Gardner, Dana Creech, and Ronnie Feist in there. FMX superstar Ronnie Feist.
Yeah, he's no stranger. He's got a little trophy truck racing as well. We'll see if that gives him an advantage here in this LCQ.
Last two spots in the main event up for grabs. Here we go.
Big jump off the line by Daryl Rath. Holy smokes, he was timed that about perfect.
Look at Feist up the inside already, 26.
Just banging his way to get that inside line. It's so important, those inside lines on that first start.
So Feist coming from the back row. He'll now try and run down Rath.
And again, you know, this track is tough. You know, you're racing the track, you're racing the other drivers. Ronnie Feist is in a transfer position. You know, how hard does he want to push for that win? Or is he just going to kind of settle back into second for that transfer spot to the main?
On board with Rath. How much does this track change over the course of a day?
You know, the ruts and the obstacles changing, you know, the jumps, they get toned down a little bit. It's changing a lot. I mean, lap to lap, I would say.
Drivers looking for traction out there on the far right. Rath gets through smooth, and now we're on board with FMX All-Star Ronnie Feist.
Yeah, he's a multi-time X Games medalist as well as a trophy truck driver, so he's no stranger to four wheels.
It seems as though two-wheel experience definitely translates to four-wheel success.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at how Rath gets through that section. I just love watching those razors through the whoops. You can really see that suspension working.
Feist now pulling a gap, all critical, because remember, just top two go to the main event.
Upside down! Oh, no!
It was all looking so good for Ronnie Feist.
You could see on the onboard him get a little sideways, and then he ends up on his side. That is, what a bummer.
You can see the disappointment there, even through the helmet and goggles. So second place now up for grabs. Andy Ives looks like he has the inside track for the moment.
Yeah, Dana Creech is right in there. You know, he's doing double duty this weekend. Not only is he racing, he's also one of our track builders.
That's Hill, who gets stuffed into the hay bales. Oh, and no. He collects Mike Gardner. So we're down to two maybe for that last spot.
Boy, Dana Creech, you see him navigate that inside corner. That's some solid driving.
Oh, Creech, you mentioned the experience. He built the course. You think he snuck some practice laps late at night?
You know, he might have got a few extra in there.
I think maybe the lack of sleep playing not in his favor, as up front, Darrell Rath continues to be smooth.
Yeah, Darrell's a veteran to our Terracross Championship, and man, just always a solid driver, always in the mix.
Negotiates both those doubles perfectly, takes the inside. That's been the popular line.
Yeah, it's really fast if you can. I mean, both lanes are equally quick depending on how you navigate them. As you can see, Creech taking the outside, gets through there clean, and it's definitely fast.
Creech trying the outside once again. Pinches him off.
Just barely got in front of. And then he's. You can just see how loose that concrete is. Creech making the move on the inside.
Runs him high. Will it work? Look at the traction
side
on the outside.
Side.
Ives with some good traction. Now he'll have the inside.
Oh my gosh, banging right through the funnel out into the outside of the stadium. I think Creech has got him.
Creech makes it stick. But look at the horsepower here, guys, coming out of the corners. You have to steady it. There's a lot of horsepower in those razors.
Yeah, these things are amazing. They're all equal, so it's really about the driver.
It looks like that second place spot's going to come down to Ives and Creech. Early, it was Ronnie Feist who thought he had it until this moment, a little high side. You got to stay on four wheels if you hope to be in the main event and win Terracross. Welcome back to the Del Mar Fairgrounds here in San Diego. Kevin Barnett alongside Paul Thacker for Terracross. We are at LCQ number two, the final two spots to the main event, and the leader right now, Darrell Rath, looking good. He has that number one spot locked up.
He's driving smooth, hitting his marks, looking really good.
Second spot, though, in question, coming through the whoops sideways. He couldn't hang on to it.
Saves it from going over. That was some good driving. And he is not happy.
Oh, Creech drives himself right out of a qualifying position, and back in now is James Hill, number 91. Hill takes the white flag, one lap to go to get himself in the main.
Yeah, Hill's in that second spot, transfer position. Ives, he's there. Yeah, well, I don't know, not much time left.
Looks like it would take a pretty big mistake from Hill to give that second qualifying position back, but we've seen that multiple times.
We definitely have. That concrete section, it's gnarly.
So there's Rath. Into the whoops, just a couple of turns from taking LCQ number two.
Yeah, Darrell's such a good driver, always smooth. No surprise to see him out front in this LCQ.
One right-hander to go, he'll funnel back in and take the checkers. We talked about a mistake, there it was! Checkered flag for Rath. Did Hill give up too much time?
91 seconds.
Looks like he was safe. He'll creep around the inside. I'm sure be quite careful here, Paul.
Yeah, his heart rate probably was elevated a little bit there, but he was able to get that thing around, come across the finish line for that last transfer spot.
Checkered flag waves, puts it through James Hill. Not before. He thought his day was done a couple of times.
Yeah, a couple of mistakes, but he was managed to make it happen.
This is Hill early on getting tangled up with Ives, and he ended up in the hay bales.
Yeah, no, that's why we race the races. You just never know what might happen.
Ives would later go around the outside. He would battle with Dana Creech, and Creech was looking good until he built the berm a little small.
Man, he got that thing on two wheels, saved it, but lost the position.
Frustration for Creech as he knew his day was done.
Look at that drive. It's like he was doing a little two-wheel stunt driving there.
Frustration indeed for our track builder, but Darrell Rath headed to the main event. Laurette Nickel caught up with him.
Well, we just saw Daryl Rath grab the win in the LCQ. Daryl, how did you stay out of trouble?
You know, I got the hole shot for once. I got the start in the front row on the LCQ, and my GBCs gave me the hole shot, and I took off and just ran my own race. I never hurt anybody, never seen anybody. Just drove around, stayed out of trouble, and tried to find some good lines, and hopefully brought them into the main.
Daryl, thank you so much. Best of luck. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Laurette. That gets us to our Polaris Power Performance, and it's James Hill, number 91, and this was a pressure performance, putting the heat on Dana Creech.
Absolutely. He came in, Dana knew he was there, comes into this left-hander, too much pressure, overdrives the corner, and Hill goes right by.
Creech coming in hot, Hill coming in second. He will advance to the main event along with Daryl Rath. They will face off with our reigning champion, Jason Luberg. He took home the 2014 championship with consistency. Let's learn more about the champ.
I come from an ATV background, been racing ATVs most of my life. I raced professional ATVs for about 10 years, and then it kind of transitions me into this pretty good. You know, it's still four wheels, just cage and seat now instead of, you know, handlebars. Yeah, I ended up winning the overall championship last year. Kind of just snuck in there. It worked out because I never had real bad luck. Just never wrecked, never anything, just kind of kept consistent. The best plan is for me to just remain consistent. I want to go out and win. I want to go out and push hard. For the most part, I try to just pay attention to what I'm going to do and what my plan is for the race. And, you know, I know the track better than anybody because we're building it. Dana and I, you know, have been building tracks for a long time together for the ATVs and now these. Building the tracks is just as much fun as racing on the tracks. And we didn't get done with the whole track in general until about 6:30 in the morning. So pulled an all-nighter, got a little bit of sleep, and then we raced all day. And, you know, it's been a long weekend, but it's fun. It's worth it.
It's fun being the defending champ out here defending his title, Jason Luberg, and the fans once again having a great time, especially those folks right there as we line up for the women's final.
Yeah, the women's racing has been so good the past couple years. I expect it to be about the same this year.
I'm glad you mentioned last year because the racing action was amazing. And if it's anything like last year, we're in for a good race coming up as we do look back last year. Sarah Price and Cindy Hart battling out up front.
I tell you what, last year left nothing to be desired. Sarah Price was just on the gas the entire race. Cindy Hart's really consistent driver. She's always up front, does really well. And then we threw Sarah Price into the mix, and she was just, as you can see, on the gas, making passes, just really driving hard.
Price, you may know her from her WMX riding, and she was putting the horsepower to the ground with these razors. It was action, fast and furious all through. Down the last lap, she had a shot.
Yeah, Sarah was sticking her nose in all over the track, trying to make the pass stick. Finally, last corner, she makes the pass, gets a little tight, high sides on the last corner before the finish line.
We talked about track changes. You didn't think you'd get a berm that would high side you and stick you up. 778 stuck, and the 55 to the win. Cindy Hart, winner last year.
Yeah, it was really some good racing, a lot of fun to watch.
Off that performance, Sarah Price is back as we look at our Optimus starter grid. Price in the 91, Shelby Anderson in the 5, Weatherly in the 8, and it'll be Vernola with the 72.
Yeah, Sarah Price on that pole position, top qualifier. You know after last year, she's hungry for a W.
Four vehicles, four drivers, and we are off. It's Price looking good out of the first turn.
Yeah, the start is so important. You can see there's a little bit of water on the track. It's going to be slick. The drivers are going to have to take that into account when they set up for the corners.
Oh, beautiful overhead shot there. Gives you a look at the inside. You can take that little bump. Which line do you think is better in some of these?
Well, as you can see last year, Sarah took that inside and got stuck. She's probably looking at the outside there.
Into this triple section, three lines available. Price goes to the outside.
Looks like all four buggies taking that outside line. There's three lines there. It's tough to make that first inside corner. The outside's a little bit easier, but it's not quite as fast.
Weatherly in second as Price negotiates that treacherous concrete section.
That stuff is so slippery, as you can see. it's really just a challenge to make that corner and make it smooth. If you can stick it right, whoa!
Up on the nose! Give the fans a little show, Weatherly. Might have been a little too much for the machine all the way on the nose. Weatherly pulling off, but Price still leading up front.
Now, Sarah's such a talented driver, it's always fun to watch. She's always on the gas.
The women's final once again providing some of the best action here at Mystic Lubricants Terracross, the over-under. We'll be right back with the finish for the women. Welcome back to the Walker Evans RJ Anderson Terracross Invitational here in Del Mar. Fans getting a good look at the women's race. White flag flies, and up front, Sarah Price.
Yeah, again, Sarah had such a fantastic race last year. It's great to see her back racing in these buggies this year. She's fast. She's got quite a lead.
Price way out front, running in second, taking the white flag there. That's the number five buggy. Shelby Anderson. That's RJ's cousin. So the title sponsor is RJ Anderson. Well,
I wonder if that gives
you
her
a spot.
Does that give her an advantage? I imagine she's got some racing background, so.
Good look there at Price as she exits. Next time she comes in, it'll be checkered flag time.
Yeah, she's navigating the course really, really well. It's the signs of a very confident woman behind the wheel there.
Well, Price is a racer. No matter what you put her behind or on, she will put the hammer down. She's done it here in our women's final. One turn to go, left-hander, and the win. Vindication from last year.
Yeah, there were no hang-ups in the last turn this year as she comes around, sticks the win. You know, she's a very talented driver. It's good to see her on the top of the box.
Definitely showed her talent. Blew the field away this year, did Sarah Price. There's a little salute to the fans.
She's pretty happy. That's great.
This was right off the start. Price on the inside, and she really got the jump and got away.
Absolutely. There was no mistakes for Sarah in this race. She nailed it. Speaking of nailing it.
There's the entertainment right there. Danielle Weatherly putting it on the nose.
Oh, my goodness.
And putting it across with the checkers was Sarah Price. Terrific victory there for Sarah Price. If you look at our Universal Technical Institute women's final results, Price in first with the number 91, followed by the number 5 of Shelby Anderson, and then number 72, Katie Vernola, comes home in third. Now let's go down and check in with Lorette Nickel, who has our Polaris Razor winners interview.
Sarah Price, with a convincing win in your event, you just grabbed that hole shot and never looked back. How did you put it all together?
Well, I know coming into this track is very technical. You have to stay calm. Like, that's the most and foremost thing that you have to do here. And so I just, I wanted to get out front as fast as I could and just ride my own race and stay calm and collected. And that's what I did, and tried making as few mistakes as I could. I'm also sharing the car with James Hill, so I have to keep it together for him and me. So we both are, working together to keep it alive. And yeah, I was super excited to pull that off, and it was a good, smooth race.
All right, well, she definitely rode her own race, taking that win. Great job, Sarah Price.
Sarah Price, first winner of 2015. Next up, the men's main event. Welcome back to the Walker Evans RJ Anderson Terracross Invitational, happening here in San Diego. And if you're out at the fair, take a chance to stop by and see Shelby Anderson, Ronnie Feist, and the like. Get an autograph and visit with some of the stars of Terracross. Here's Katie Vernola handing out to some young fans. Fans have filled the stands, the track is ready, and we are about to get underway with our main event. 16 laps of fantastic cage-to-cage racing. RJ Anderson on the pole. Jason Luberg, 2014 champ, right next to him. Let's go to Lorette.
Thanks, guys. Well, Jason Luberg told me that he felt that he had snuck through the 2014 season in order to clinch that championship. However, we saw him make an incredible statement. What did you learn last year that you're going to apply to this racing season?
I'm just trying to stay consistent, not break the razor. A lot of these fast guys, you know, we break. They all break, so it's just a matter of who breaks the least amount.
Well, best of luck. We hope you don't break. Guys, back to you.
Now, Paul, you know they are pushing these things to the limit racing. So look at our starting grid here. RJ Anderson on the pole position. Right next to him, there is Luberg. Watch that off the start.
Yeah, I know. You know, Jason is, he's last year he didn't actually win a race, came in a bit under the radar. This year he's definitely not. Cole Coutu, one of our younger competitors, he's wicked fast.
Cody Rodgers out of Alpine, California, sitting in the middle there in row two, along with Brandon Sims, who could factor. Next to him, Mickey Thomas. Thomas showed some flair last year in this Terracross.
Yeah, he's one of our younger competitors as well. He's fast.
And here's a guy we'll check in with throughout this main event, our GoPro onboard with Chris Barant. Our Optimus starters start list, and RJ Anderson up front covered that. In the back, Vaught, Barant, LaValle, Rath, Sylvester, and Hill, who we've seen come through those LCQs. Second board gone. We're just about to get underway. This is an incredible amount of buggies on a small space.
Look at all those razors. Good jump for RJ. Cole Coutu on the outside as well. RJ gets that all-important hole shot. Look at all those. That's just a crazy amount of razors on the track at one time.
RJ a little wide and a lot of banging going on in the back. No surprise. And coming into the stadium for the very first time,
oh,
RJ's up front, but upside down.
Colton Moore upside down right off the bat. That is not the way he wanted to start this season.
Mickey Thomas in second. Cole Coutu in third.
You can see all of the guys taking that inside line, that first lap in the triple lane section. Obviously that inside. Oh, no.
Spin out from Luber.
Big spin. Some big traffic jam on the concrete.
Well, the beneficiaries of that are the top three. They're going to have some room.
Oh, no!
Oh, the right front. RJ.
The Mystic Mangler looks like claims RJ Anderson on the first lap. Oh, that's not what he wanted there.
And those are the issues from last year for RJ. We saw this one race would go well, one race wouldn't.
Yeah, you know, these razors are so tough, but the, you know, racing on these tracks really puts them through the paces. And then you add the banging into each other, and it's tough.
Coutu and Thomas up front. Green flag still waving. Lap one, always an adventure at Terracross.
You know, there's so much time left. Anything can happen, but Cole Coutu looks so good right now. He actually wicked fast on a snowmobile. He actually won the sport class moving up to the pros. Looking pretty solid on the track right now.
So the Hanco Utilities Fox-sponsored ride of Cole Coutu is up front. He is trailed closely by the Mystic Lubricants, ATVRider.com, Mickey Thomas.
Oh, no!
Oh, Coutu!
Coutu, again, that concrete section is so key. Tough to get through there smooth, as you just watched Cole Coutu demonstrate.
So the Mystic Lubricants driver, Mickey Thomas, he inherits the lead. Boy, it looks fast coming out of there.
You know, last year he really showed some serious talent. This year, picking up right where he left off.
Oh, more action in the back. Cody Rodgers on his side. And now red flags all around gives us a chance to check in with our in-race analyst, Chris Barant.
Red flag. I had one flip right in front of me. Saw RJ stuck in the wall. Just craziness.
So forget sitting up in the announcer's tower. We have guys right down on track in the action. And all that action coming just in the first couple of laps. Much more to come here, Terracross main event. We'll be right back. The Walker Evans RJ Anderson Terracross Invitational continues here on CBS Sports Network from the Del Mar Fairgrounds. Kevin Barnett alongside Paul Facker calling all this exciting racing action. It's been a whole weekend of racing action. Jim Beavers, Motorsports Show, the Down and Dirty, talking there with Dana Creech and Katie Vernola, who rode together in the women's final.
And Jim Beaver was actually doing a little double duty, a little radio show, a little driving. As you can see, didn't quite make the final. He ended up upside down qualifying a couple times, so that tends to make it tough to race in the main.
All right, so Beaver had double duty. Maybe you and I can get in some UTVs for the next race.
I'm ready, man. Sign me up.
All right, red flag has flown, so we have a restart. This is good. This is one of the best things about Terracross. Tighten the field back up.
Yeah, it really is cool. Stacks them all back up. 20-year-old Mickey Thomas. Man, the kid's talented. Driving hard out front again.
Restart, same two guys up front. Thomas will be followed by Hanco Utilities' Cole Couture there in the 21. Look at the battle for third into the first couple of turns.
Man, there's a lot of banging in those corners when those guys all get stacked up like that.
Let's go to our GoPro on board with Mickey Thomas up front.
You can see Mickey sawing on that steering wheel, taking that inside line. Again, there's three lane choices there, but everybody seems to really want that inside lane.
Back into the concrete, Luberg there, trying to make some progress. There's our guy, Chris Brandt. Let's check in with him on the concrete.
All right, guys, coming into this crazy section. It is so slippery. There's so much dirt, and you're just on concrete. And this tire section coming into, oh, man, it's gnarly. You just got to launch yourself straight up in the air. Huge ruts coming into this. Back outside.
Good job, Chris. Get back to racing, man.
And I tell you what, that's got to be tough doing double duty like that. Good for him. Talented driver.
There is Monster Energy and Fox's Chris Barrant going through that left-hander. He'll saw it back to the right and head back into the stadium. Inside the stadium and up front is Mystic Lubricants' Mickey Thomas.
Boy, I tell you what, the 20-year-old is looking like a grizzled veteran right now. No mistakes. Solid driving so far in this main event.
Remember, in this factory class, all the UTVs totally stock.
Absolutely. This track especially really separates the good drivers. As you said, all the machines are exactly the same. So it's who drives the best, keeps their car in one piece, is going to win this race.
Getting through clean, sliding through his Hanco Utilities' Cole Couture. Still trying to make up ground on Thomas. There's our guy, Chris Barrant. He gets claimed by the Mystic Mangler. Trying to merge back on the 5 here in San Diego.
Yeah, it's a busy freeway right there.
Back on board now with Jason Luberg, defending champ.
Luberg sitting in third place. That's, you know, he's that sleeper dark horse. He likes, like, sneaking in there. That's how he won the championship last year, and he's picking up right where he left off.
Oh, there's our guy Chris Barrant leaving the track.
Just broke guys right on those tires.
So Barrant done for this main event. And going to the outside, just hanging on is Mickey Thomas.
And Cole Couture, you can see him coming in, getting just about doing a 360, saving it to keep that second spot.
Great look at what goes on in the cockpit of these UTVs.
Just the guys bouncing around. Those 5-point harnesses are absolutely necessary in this Terracross racing.
They're really showing you what these factory Polaris Razor 1000s are capable of.
Boy, Mickey Thomas is looking pretty solid out front, but Cole Couture's keeping him honest.
Across the finish line, Thomas once again. Okay, he's up almost 3 seconds. Is that a lot or a little in Terracross?
Boy, I tell you what, we're on lap 5, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds. That's not really a whole lot of time when you're at this stage of the race. You know, anything can happen at this point.
Next time across the finish line, we'll be halfway. Down the concrete comes Thomas. No. There's a mistake.
Like I said, anything can happen. It just happened.
It just did. Couture right up on the bumper.
Wow, that 3 seconds disappeared awfully quick.
All right, we'll see how Mickey Thomas responds to that error.
Well, it looks like he's really collected himself well, getting through that section smooth. Man, he had the old heart was pumping, but he's dealing with the pressure.
Well, I continue to be impressed with the lines at Thomas. Those rear wheels seem to just dig in and push forward.
Yeah, it just amazes me the abuse that these Polaris Razor 1000s take. I mean, the tracks are so difficult, and then you add, you know, banging and bumping with other buggies, man, it's impressive.
Thomas hanging on into that left-hander. Oh, all the way wide, using every bit of that
berm.
Katsu! He could have used some berm.
Boy, I tell you, that berm saved him. Almost went all the way around, collected himself, lost a little bit of time, but it could have been a whole lot worse. Man, you can see how slippery that concrete section is. These guys are really having a difficult time navigating.
Man and machine being pushed to their limits here in Del Mar. The two youngsters up front, but don't forget about Jason Luberg. He's lurking in third place. We'll have the finale of the men's main coming up next.
The 2015 Terracross Championships on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Polaris Razor and by Mystic Lubricants, the official racing lubricant of Terracross. Learn more at mysticlubes.com.
The wheel-to-wheel action of Terracross continues as you are on board with Mickey Thomas, who is up front. Number 44, the young man has driven admirably.
The 20-year-old has ice water in his veins, not letting anything get to him, driving really, really well, hitting his marks.
He's going to have to continue hitting his marks because right behind him is Cole Coutu, another youngster, and then the champ, the reigning number one plate of Jason Luberg.
Luberg in same form as last year. He's in that third spot. Is he going to be content, or is he going to push for a win?
We'll see. Shred the berm. All three guys all the way outside using the entire racetrack.
Oh.
And now sliding is Thomas.
Oh, wow. That was a Thomas with a great corner. Coutu with a mistake. Luberg on the inside.
It's Luberg. He'll be on the outside. Coutu. Cars everywhere.
Wow. The Mystic Mangler. Just so gnarly, those guys getting over that, getting bounced all over the place.
The beneficiary of all that action is Thomas, who gets a couple more seconds. Coutu and Luberg still in the picture. All that work from Luberg, nothing gained.
Thomas is driving extremely well, under pressure, under duress. The kid is making it happen.
White flag out for Mickey Thomas. Everybody within 6 seconds. Still not much in Terracross.
Yeah, we're on white flag lap. This is our final lap around the track. Mickey Thomas is looking pretty good out front. It's going to take a mistake in order for him to lose that position.
Looks like he banked off that on purpose way to the outside. That's a thing
of beauty.
I
tell you what, that was a perfect corner. Excellent drift. Kid's on point.
Coutu not quite as smooth, but enough to hold off Luberg for the moment.
Mickey Thomas coming out of the arena. Couple corners. He's looking for that first Terracross victory.
25 points on the line in the championship. Luberg looks like he's set for another podium spot. Nice and smooth through there. That'll do it. Probably left hand and checkered flag coming up.
The 20-year-old has made it happen. Boy, what a solid day of driving for that kid.
Coutu thumbs up in second. Good start for him to the year. Remember, 6-race series. This just the first. And in third, Keystone Automotive and Lone Star Racing's Jason Luberg picking up right where he left off in 2014.
Absolutely. He was the epitome of consistency last year. It's great to see him starting the season off with a podium this year.
Winner X gold medalist Colton Moore pulling in fourth place right next to him. And taking a victory lap, the number 44, Mickey Thomas. Well, he takes a lap. We'll take a look back at this race and how it shook down. As usual, a lot of changes throughout a Terracross main event.
Yeah, RJ Anderson with a great start on the inside. Cole Coutu I tell you what, man, that outside line is tough. He made it work.
Anderson's buggy giving up a right front early on. Katsu, the beneficiary, he would slide into the lead, and then he would slide on out of it.
You know, this was actually a great save by Katsu. This could have been a whole lot worse. He keeps it on four wheels, loses a position, but was able to recover for a second place.
Mystic Lubricants, ATVRider.com. Mickey Thomas with the win. Let's go to our Polaris Razor winner's interview with Lorette.
With his first win in Terracross, your whole history of riding out here, Mickey, congratulations. You just rode your own race, didn't you?
Yeah, it was really a great race. I got out in front and, you know, I got some clean air early. RJ hit the K-rail coming up the tires and that took him out. So once I got out in front, it was just clean air, clean racing, and was able to hold the car together and get the win.
Well, great job. Thank you so much. Guys, back to you.
As we take a look at our Universal Technical Institute final results, Thomas up front, Katsu in second, two youngsters. The champ just grinding along.
Colton Moore, our X Games gold medalist from last year. Nice to see him moving towards the top, maybe a podium next race.
It was everything we expected in Terracross. Buggies everywhere, action for the fans, excitement and nose stands. What a way to start the 2015 championship. For my partners, Lorette Nickel, Paul Thacker, and our entire crew, I'm Kevin Barnett. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports.